The other important collaboration, which started in the mid-70s, was Roald Dahl, and that's the best known of them. And I think that was about 76 or something like that. And which is one of the questions you get asked, you know, did you, how did that come about? Did you know him anyway or something like that? And it was, in fact, to begin with, it was completely professional, as it were. I was published by Jonathan Cape. Dahl moved from his previous publishers to Jonathan Cape and sort of brought one book with him, I think, which was Danny, the Champion of the World. I think maybe that was had already been commissioned. I'm not quite clear about that. But Tom Maschler, who was in charge of children's books, everything actually at that time at Jonathan Cape, but including children's books, I think must have suggested to him that he might write a picture book, because Roald hadn't done that before. He'd just done sort of novels for children of different lengths. And that was The Enormous Crocodile. And then they looked for a picture book illustrator for that. And I was invited to do a sample. I think Tom thought it would be a good idea if I did it. Roald, I think, didn't have a view about it then. He was good about visual things, but I don't think he had a view about who would do it. Except I think he thought, or at least according to Tom, which he writes in his reminiscences, his book of memoirs, that I think Dahl was a bit apprehensive because he thought it should be someone possibly with a less distinctive style. Which you can imagine, I mean, as a point of view. But anyway, and I think probably they invited other people to try it because I heard from New York that somebody had been asked to do something. But I don't know about that. I just know that I did some samples and was given the manuscript and asked to do it. And as far as we knew then, I mean, it was just that book. The Dahl's books previously had been illustrated by various people, some in America and some in England and so on. But it was... there were various things that were interesting about it. My meetings about it were in the publisher's office between Tom Maschler and Roald and me. I hadn't done a picture book quite like that. It was sharper, or whatever the word is, in certain respects. I mean, it was more about mean tricks and that sort of thing. Also, it was actually much longer than most of the picture books, which is a special sort of professional problem, because there's quite a lot of text on every page. If you're going to get into 32 pages, which is the normal length, I mean, some picture books are 40 or 48 pages, but the publisher is really aiming for 32 if possible. And that was quite a lot of text, and it worked as a picture book because there are certain very kind of potent visual ideas in it, but it was still partly written as a just so story or something like that, so that there's quite a lot of text on each page, which means that not to make it look like a book with little drawings in the margin, but to look like a picture book, you have to paint in the sky very often so that you can have an orange sky or a pink sky or something with text on it. And then so that it looks like a full-page drawing, but in fact, two-thirds of it is actually the story.